Oh, no. Today, our village is feeling better, because it's now more improved. Also improved. So, students came outside today from the room, maximum half an hour was on us. I think, one room was already full. So, now we are very happy, because today, more improved. Shatpat bhi pehle the, ek hafte ke liye, udhar kuch samay ke shatpat. To is tarah se, humne suna hai, madhu marat ne bataya, ki abhi, thoda acha feeling kar rahe hain, ki hum aasa karte hain, dhire dhire, aur garanti. Sharaprasam, Asmadiya Paramatma Tamakru Paspatmuni, Asakrupoti, Jagavat Pranati, Gyanantam. Tadrantaram Pasti, Pujaniya Sanyasiya, Samastamishna Vya, Sajjano, Matai, Beno, Hayo, Sanito, Nira, Pranam, Nividan. Aaj, Girdaji ki Adi Parikrama mein Radha Kunda ji ho, Achi Prakas se Bina Kisi Durgatna ki, Parikrama, Sustarup se Sampannam hui, Jo hum sabhi, Samay ke Anurup, Yahan par, Samay Anusar, Hum Yahan Upastit Ho Rahe, Aur Sabhi Ne Dogan Ko Vahan Prasad Kiya Kiya Hai. Jo ki, Radha Kunda mein Hume Sab Kuch Na Kuch Khatra Rehta Hai Ye, Pani Mein. To Isliye, Sab Hume Ek Badi Chinta Rehti Hai. Jo ki, Koi Khatre Se, Hum Mukt Rahe Hain, Ab Ki Saab, Koi Hamare Paas Aisi Koi Durgatna Ki Samasya Nahi Kiya Hai. Dusri Baat, Aaj Hum Log Gaye Radha Kunda. Vahan Ki Kathaya Kuch Hui Hai. Parantu Aaj Sabhi Bhaktam Se Nivedan Karte Hain, Aaj Jashko Yagruva, Jashko Yagruva, Jashko Yagruva, Radha Rani, Aur Radha Kunda. But not only one matter, so many different kind Radha Kunda can speak, take and nuance. By Jashko Yagruva, then everyone can speak. But today we have done, In Vishnu Puran, Ko Jadha Radha Priya Vishnu Stasya, Kundam Priyam Tatha. भगवान श्री कृष्ण के जैसे राधा जी सर्वाधिक प्यारी हैं, सर्वश्रेष्ठ प्रियतमा है, उनसे बढ़कर और कोई श्रेष्ठ सती नहीं है। वैसे उनका प्रिय कुंड राधा कुंड भी वैसा ही श्री कृष्ण का प्रिय है। क्यों प्रिय है? जो सर्व गोपीशु सेवई का जहाँ समस्त गोपियां सेवा करती है, राधा जी का बलान पूर्ण करती है, उनके भाव का ग्रहण कर सब श्याम सुंदर की सेवा करती है, ऐसे राधा जी की महिमा कुछ वर्णन करें। इसलिए मैं निवेदन करता हूँ, सबसे पहले that
If, this thing said, if we take all of the outlets of like Mr. that they cannot equal, even one speck of dust in the dark. But to the Mahatma Dasa Swami, he has said in his Rajvilas Dhamma, he said that even if you take the supremely delightful pastime places of Vrindavan, which are filled with so many rasadis, and if you take also Sri Govardhan, which is the arena of the lowest nectarian pastimes, where most confidential amorous pastimes take place, he said that all of this does not equal even a shadow of one speck of dust of Sri Radha. So, how was it beyond to be taken to this place by Sri Gurudev? That of all places in the universe, material and spiritual, that there's no place that even equals a shade of a speck of dust of Radha. It's stated that there's different types of vision, that when we come to the Holy Ground and still we're conditioned by material energy, then this vision is Drishyaman Prakash. For those whose eyes have been anointed with love, Premanjana Srita Bhakti Vilochanena Santas Deva Vishyosh Lokayanti, that for them, that they actually see the Sroop of Sri Radhakum. Srila Gurudev is explained in his Parikram book that in Radhakum it is surrounded by kunjas of the different sakis. That the northern part of Radhakum, near the place of Srila Radhakundasa Swami's Bhajan Kutir, that is the northwestern part. So the northern part is the kunj of Sri Lalita. And this kunj is surrounded by gold, sapphires, crystal, and other jewels. But these jewels are not like the jewels of this material world. It's stated in Tamanika Karasabra Kalpariksha that these jewels in Chintamani, they're transcendental jewels. And the jewels that we have in this material world, the diamonds, the sapphires, the emeralds, the rubies, the pearls, that they're just reflections of the transcendental reality that exists in the transcendental world. And to the highest degree, they manifest in Sri Radhakum. So, we are seeing having one darshan of Sri Radhakum, and still that is so supremely purifying, so supremely exhilarating. But the darshan of personalities like Srila Gurudev, whose eyes are anointed with love, then they're actually seeing the real Swarup of Radhakum. That it is surrounded with transcendental gems. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, in his Gita Mala, he said that in Radhakum, that the trees which are there, Chintamani trees, that they manifest a different type of precious transcendental stones. To the northwest is Vishakhadevi's Kunj. And there, or to the northeast, and there is also surrounded with different varieties of pearls and transcendental jewels. To the east is the Kunj of Chitrasakhi. And it's stated that this is a multicolored kunj. To the southeast is the Kunj of Vindulekha. And this is manifesting transcendental diamonds that are illuminating that kunj. To the south is the Kunj of Chakrapalata. And that kunj is also the shape of a golden lotus, supremely effulgent. To the southwest is the Kunj of Ramadevi. And this is very inspiring to Srimati Radhika because it is populated with sapphires, blue sapphires, which are reminding her of Krishna. And in the West, the Kunja of Tungavidya, which is manifesting red rubies. And in the center, there is Swananda Sukhna Kunj, in the center of Radha Kunj. And from Swananda Sukhna Kunj, there's a bridge of moonstones, which are leading towards the northern part of Radha Kunj, the place where there's a sitting place of Jagannatha-Rani. So, in the verse I quoted in the beginning, it stated, Koyam Asya, that who will not want to reside in this Shivanapur? We see that our previous acharyas, Srila Raghunandas Goswami, Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, Srila Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur, and so many others, they came and they resided and they did their bhajan in this Shivanapur. And in their bhajan, then pastimes of Krishna and his associates were manifested in their hearts. So Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, in his Govinda Lilamrita, he explains that Krishna, he was in Radha Kunj, and Srimati Radhika, suffering intense pains of separation, that she's being led towards Radha Kunj by Ganesha Sakhi, Kundalaka, Lalita Vishaka on either side, and the mantris holding different paraphernalia. As she's going towards Radha Kunj, then a breeze is carrying the aroma coming from Krishna's body, that it's like the mixture of blue lotus flowers and musk. And when this breeze enters into her nostrils, there's Srimati Radhika, in separation, there's a meeting, and she starts to feel states of ecstasy. Simultaneously, Krishna Radha Kunj, he is also experiencing so much separation from Srimati Radhika, and the breeze coming from her body also reaches Krishna, and Krishna wants to fly like a bumblebee towards the honey-like love of Srimati Radhika. But instead, he sends Vrindadevi with a message. So as Srimati Radhika is coming with her sakhis, then she meets Vrindadevi. And Vrindadevi, without saying anything, she has two very beautiful blue lotus flowers, which have anointed the ears of Krishna. And she very sweetly places these lotus flowers on the ears of Srimati Radhika. And now Srimati Radhika, being anointed with the lotus flowers of Krishna, she almost goes into a state of ecstasy where she loses consciousness. But regaining her consciousness, she asks her, Kasmatmande Priyasaki, the old Vrindavan, where are you coming from? She is wearing the lotus flowers which have anointed the ears of Krishna, and she is also feeling so much ecstasy, and she knows where Vrindavan is coming from. But she's asking, Kasmatmande Priyasaki? And Vrindadevi replies, Hare Padmula, I'm coming from Krishna's association. And Srimati Radhika asks, Kutoso, where is he? And she replies, Kundaranya, that he's in the forest of Radha Kunj. What is he doing? And she replies, Nityashiksha, that she's learning dancing. Srimati Radhika, now she becomes very alert. She's learning dancing. Who's teaching dancing? Guruka. Who's teaching? And then she replies, oh, Tuan Bhuti, that your form, that she's seeing this form in every tree, in every creeper, in every leaf, in every direction. And just as all of Radha Kunj, praying Amrita Plavanas, that Radha Kunj is inundated and overflowing with the prayer of Srimati Radhika. And all of Radhapur, all the trees, all the leaves are also inundated with that moon. And Krishna there, he's learning dancing. Srila Krishnadas Kavata Swami has stated, Radhika Prem Guru Amisasuna, that this love of Srimati Radhika, specifically this love as Srimati Radhapur, that this is Guru of Krishna. And Sada Amananamite the joy of that this love is making Krishna like a pupil. And as the love is moving, Krishna is dancing so many love dances according to the tune. That Srila Raghunathas Goswami, that he has stated,
Agaripuapiyatna Atradevya Prasada Prasada Vita Kataksha Prakta Kama Kama Anusaradiya Luce Snam Seva Nupandas Jarasi Suradi Rata Kunda Nivasriyoshe.
That Krishna, please take yourselves to Radhapur. That not only our acharyas, but Krishna himself, the Supreme Lord, that when he wants to achieve this object of bhajan, then there's no best place than going to Radhapur. And there, he's taking bath 3 times a day. He's performing, he's chanting, performing austerities. And there, he's meditating and he's crying for Srimati Radhika. Then, in the Brihad Gautamiya Tantra, I think Pushpapada says to Manaj, I have got this pastime from him. That suddenly, Krishna, he's in Radhapur. And Srimati Radhika is in Maan. And she's not giving him darshan. And Krishna, wanting how to achieve darshan of Srimati Radhika, that there in Radhapur he's performing austerities. And what austerities is he performing? That the chief limb of bhakti, that this is Nam-Sankirtan. So he's performing Nam-Sankirtan. But which Nam is he chanting? He's chanting Radha-Nam. So Krishna, he's there in Radhapur and he's chanting Radhe, 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 Radhe,
Radhe, Radhe, Radhe, Radhe, Radhe, Radhe,
Radhe, Radhe, Radhe, Radhe, Radhe, Radhe, Radhe, Radhe, Radhe, Radhe,
Srimati Radhika, she's in Maan, that hearing that Krishna is crying for her and he's calling out her name, that her heart melts. And then she comes unbeknownst to Krishna and she comes to Radhapur. And lo and behold, she sees that Shamsun is there, absorbed with his eyes closed, tears flowing from his eyes, chanting Radhanam. Srimati Radhika, she becomes she tells Shamsunda that, oh, that this is not proper, that you chant my name like this, lover and beloved, that this is not proper, this is crossing social etiquette. So she gives him another mantra to chant so that she can remember him, so that he can remember her, but in a hidden way. And then she gives this mantra.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Sri Ramakund is the most supreme place. That it is superlative in different ways. That here, Krishna is performing his Madhya Lila, his midday pastimes. And in these pastimes, then, during this period of the day, then twice a month of time is given for pastimes. And also, in this period, in this place, there's Srimati Radhika, she's manifesting her Madhinath Mahabhava without restriction. Then in other places, like Prem Sarovar, also this mood of Madhinath Mahabhava is manifest, but only sometimes. But in Sri Radhakund, Prem Amrita Ladana, that it is overflowing and all are affected in this mood. And as we said before, in Vrindavan, in the autumn grass dance, then so many different types of gopis are there. In Govinda, in the spring grass dance, not just the gopis are there, but different parties are there, different Radha's party, etc. But in Radhakund, only Srimati Radhika's party allowed entrance. And also another very, very special aspect of Sri Radhakund, that the mandaris, the younger sisters of Srimati Radhika, that they have no desire to meet with Krishna separately. But in Radhakund, by tricks, that Srimati Radhika also is arranging meeting between the mandaris and Krishna. So in so many ways, that this Sri Radhakund is the supreme place of bhajan, the supreme place of worship, and just offering my obeisances and hoping that one day I'll be able to realize something, even a vast, a shadow of a shadow of a shadow of the speck of the glorious brother.
Rupa Goswami is the Shikshaguru. So, Srila Raghunatha Das Goswami didn't write philosophical works, pure lyrical descriptions of pastimes of Radha Krishna. And in Vilasmus Manjali, he's presenting his heartfelt pleas for service to Srimati Radhika in a very special way. Srila Gurudev has explained his process of bhajan under the influence of yoga maya. Sometimes he's completely in inner consciousness, totally absorbed in his identity as Srimati Manjari, and performing very beautiful service to the lotus feet of Radha Krishna and especially to Srimati Radhika. Because his mood is Radhapali Dasim, that he is she, Radhi Manjari, is completely absorbed in her service to Srimati Radhika. And then sometimes, under the influence of yoga maya, that meditation breaks. And then he's rolling on the ground, half inward consciousness, half outward consciousness, rolling on the ground, crying and crying for his service. So these separation moods are so important, so precious for us. Because his separation, his eternal associate with the Lord, he's come here, he's appearing to be a Raghunatha Sadhu, coming to perfection. But actually he's eternal associate with the Lord. And when he's separated from his service, it is so intense. So the whole area is saturated with his mood of separation. And then sometimes he's in external consciousness, crying and crying, and writing these very exquisite and ecstatic poems of prayer to Srimati Radhika for the specific services throughout the day. So Srila Gurudev quoted three verses, Tavaivasmi, Madhi Bhavami Tvayana, Hirika Radheta, Nayamam Charanam Pike. O Srimati Radhika, I'm yours. Nothing else, I'm yours. This is my identity, it's the essence of my being. I can't live without you. So, knowing this, you should bring me to your lotus feet. So then Srimati Radhika may ask, okay, your mind, but what relationship do we have? You have very intense mamata, you have very intense sense of possessiveness, but what is that relationship? So then Raghunatha Das Goswami prays, Pada jayosta bhagada darasanta dasmeva nanyat tidapi samayikarin deviyate sukhyayate mama namostu namostu nityam dasyayate mama namostu namostu satsam. What kind of relationship do I want? I want to be a dasya. All of the mantras are perfectly qualified to be Yudhishthira. They're perfectly qualified to have their own groups as sakis of Srimati Radhika. But Raghunatha Das Goswami says, I don't want that. Satyayate mama namostu namostu nityam. I offer obeisances to the opportunity of becoming your saki, like Lalita Vishakha Chakraparta and so on. But I don't want. I offer obeisances from a distance. Dasyayate mama rasostu rasostu satyam. So what is that mellow, what is that taste of service that really draws me on, or it's a mood of service to your lotus feet. Dasis, mantras, they're performing services that Lalita Vishakha cannot perform. They're performing services to Radha Krishna together, and they're also performing services to Srimati Radhika, very, we can say, menial services. Sometimes Radhi Mantri in the morning, she's sweeping the floor with her hair. And then washing the drains with water, perfuming the whole place with incense, then washing Srimati Radhika's lotus feet, drying her lotus feet with her hair, massaging her, taking her for a bath. So many beautiful pastimes, so many beautiful services. She doesn't want to be separated from those services. But what is the specific service? What kind of service? What kind of service do you want? Then, Shri Rupa Manjari Garaj Tathara Padma Goshtin Dananta Nabujar Padamashtakaya Ha Modata Kanako Vadara Vayura Sambhana Salakas Talakim Karishya. Oh, when will that time come? Radha and Krishna will be performing their very beautiful amorous pastime. And now they're relaxing. Shri Rupa Manjari has come into the Nikunja and she's very gently massaging touching. Beautiful golden lotus feet. Shrimati Rati is golden lotus feet. And Rati Mantri is beeping. And like sometimes when devotees are lucky to massage Gurudev, so then one of the devotees was massaging with his eyes to indicate to somebody else, oh, you come and massage this part of Gurudev's lotus, his legs or his arm like this. And then some lucky person can come forward. So Rup Mantri is indicating with the eyes, and then Rati Mantri is coming and also performing this very beautiful pastime of service of massaging Shrimati Radhika's lotus feet. Very intimate pastime, very close service to Shrimati Radhika. So this is the prayer of this is the prayer of Srila Raghunath Das Goswami that Srila Gurudev explained. This is the basis of Rampalya Dasa, Mantri Bhava, this desire. So Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, he was performing his bhajan on the banks of Radhapani. We heard this morning how renounced. His austerity was like mines in stone. Why? Because of his intense love, his intense absorption in service. He wasn't deliberately performing severe austerities. When he got to Radhapani, he wasn't taking solid food. He was just drinking a little buttermilk. And then lamenting, why just once a day? And somebody brought buttermilk in a big cup from Sakistan, and he was chastising, wanted to beat him with a stick. Just wanted a little buttermilk, and while he's drinking, he's lamenting, why am I spending so much time maintaining this stupid body, rotten body? This is his austerity. And Srila Gurudev has said, in some lifetime, you will have to perform bhajan like Srila Raghunath Das Goswami. So we're so fortunate that under the guidance of Srila Gurudev and his associates, we've come to Radhakund. We've heard from Srila Gurudev the very confidential moods of service there. We're not going as tourists. Srila Gurudev and his devotees, they're helping us to make personal relationship with Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, Radhakund, Shyamakund, with Sri Ananda Manjari, with Janava Devi. Like this. First, the relationship. So, taking these precious impressions in our hearts and praying to these great personalities, we pray that the moods of service that Sri Radhakund someday will come into our heart by Gurudev's grace. Vanchakata Buddha Sakhara Sundar. Sundar and Bhadi, your voice is very good. Sri Madhusudan Mahesh. Good evening.
Vedanta Narayana Swami Maharaj ke charan kamalon mein anand koti dhanan par निपाल गया उस पर प्रतिवेदन तीर्थ महाराज एवं अंजन अंजन सभी के प्रति जथा जो जानवर अभिवादन करते हुए आज सर्वों के हैं की कृपा की प्रार्थना करता हूँ। प्रति कुमार जी जन वैष्णव सभी के प्रति महाराज जी के आदेश अनुसार राधा की महिमा कुंजय महिमा जी है राधा कुंड के कहने महिमा कहने से राधा जी का ही महिमा कब क्योंकि राधा और राधा कुंड अलग वस्तु नहीं है। जो राधा वही राधा कुंड है, जो राधा कुंड वही राधा उनका ही प्रेम छलित होकर श्याम सुंदर को कारोबार कर तथा राधा प्रिया विष्णु दस्तक कुंडम किया। ये राधा तत्व तो बहुत गंभीर और गुण है, लेकिन गंभीर गुण होने पर भी जो इनके पश्चिम लोग हैं इनसे जो प्रेम करते हैं प्रीति करते हैं वो अपने स्वामी की महिमा को जगत में सबसे ऊपर करके रखना चाहिए। इसलिए छुपा करके बुला करके चाहे किन डरे जब तक उनकी महिमा को गान नहीं करते तब तक उनको संतुष्टि और प्रीति नहीं। सर्व प्रमाण शिरोमणि श्रीमद् भागवत जी में सुखदेव जी शुरू से लेकर अंत तक केवल राधा जी के महिमा का ग्रंथ, लेकिन कृष्ण कथा को उन्हें इससे बोला तो कृष्ण को न गाने पाई राधे का चरण पाई राधा को न गाने कृष्ण का। लेकिन जहां पर मंगलाचरण आरंभ किया और जहां पर भागवत जी को विश्राम दिए है उस पर क्रम संहार में राधा जी को महिमा को स्मूल रूप से परिचित को बताए बहुत दया कर इतने गुण रहस्य उन्होंने उनके सामने उद्घाटित किए। इतने परिचित बाद में उत्तरा माता को इस सारी कथा सुनाए जो वीर भगवता मुझे जहां पर क्रम किए मंगलाचरण कर रहे हैं नमो नमस्वस्तुभाय सातवताम विदुरकाष्ठाय मोस्कुजोगिनाम निरस्त साम्यातीतेन राधसा स्वधामनी ब्रह्मणि गंसतेन। वो जो राधा तत्व है वो साधारण व्यक्तियों के लिए बहुत दूर है। योगी नाम जो रूपानुगुरु वर्गों का अनुग्रह नहीं है उनसे बहुत और जो अपने धाम में असमूल रूप से धाम करने से राधा कुंड तो उनका अपना सबसे ऊंचा स्थान है स्वधामनी ब्रह्मणी। यहाँ पर सुखदेव जी राधा जी को ब्रह्म का प्रतिपादन किया क्योंकि जो ब्रह्म का जो तेज है कृष्ण का जो प्रकाश और आधार है भर्गो देव से जो पहले भी सुने कुछ महाराज जी महाराज जी बोले तो राधा जो भगवान का भी भगवान है ब्रह्म का भी ब्रह्म है भगवान को भगवान श्री राधा क्योंकि बिना राधा भगवान का कोई परिचय नहीं मिलता। आतक रहित सूरज नहीं जानी और राधा रहित माधव नहीं मानी। अगर कृष्ण से राधा जी को अलग कर दिया जाए अलग तो हो नहीं सकते लेकिन तर्क किया जाए तो कृष्ण का भी साक्षात्कार दर्शन नहीं हो सकता। अंधेरा हो जाएगा अंधकार में क्या देखोगे काला दिखाई पड़ेगा। राधा जी के साथ ही उनके प्रकाश में कृष्ण का दर्शन हो जाता साक्षात्कार। इसलिए कहे वो जो राधा जो है जो अपने स्वरूप शक्ति से सबको अतिक्रमण कर दिया कोई तुलना करेंगे जिनको नहीं पाती करेंगे किससे तुलना देंगे किसके साथ प्रतियोगिता में रखेंगे। लक्ष्मी लक्ष्मी क्या करेंगे गोपी लक्ष्मी तमा राधा गोपी तमा गोवा अक्षर समारोह सारी गोपियां जो है लक्ष्मी तो श्रेष्ठा है और सारे गोपियों के राधा रानी सर्व सर्व गोपी दूसरे रहे का विश्वर अत्यंत बंद इनके रूप में गुण में लीला में शील में कला में रामा बराबरी नहीं करती गोटिया में जिनकी समस्या नहीं पड़ती सबसे ऊपर की राशि सर्व भावक्रम राशि माधनो अय पर राजते हराते सार राधा देवज तो जहां सुखदेव उपक्रम में राजसा वो जो अपने स्वरूप शक्ति से अपने
आपके साथ प्रतिक्रमण करके भी जाते हैं, उसी को जब शेष में उसका नाग है तो वहां पर उसी तत्व को स्थापित परिचित तो पूर्ण भजन का एक सौभाग्य प्रदान किए। भगवान जी बोले आप ब्रह्म परम धाम ब्रह्मा परम पदम इति समीक्षण आत्मान आत्मनि अध्याय निष्कर्ष। बड़ा विचित्र लगता है कि पूरी कथा भागवत के बाद जब ये कहे कि मैं ब्रह्म हूं ब्रह्म में एक हो जाऊंगा ऐसा मान लो ब्रह्म में लगा दो ब्रह्म साधित प्राप्त कर लो तो सुखदेव जी का शायद सिद्धांत तो सब गड़बड़ा जाए। कहीं पर उन्होंने ऐसा नहीं कहा, जगह जगह पर जीव को भगवान का दास सेवक क्या स्थापित किया क्योंकि सेवक सेव भाव नहीं हूं भावना तरह को लगाए यह गुण आज दे रहे हैं भागवत जी ये मोहनी स्वरूप है। जैसे बोले आदि मन अवस्था युक्त बैराग अखंड संतम हरि लीला कथा प्रातः अमृता नंदित तत्व जो भक्त उसी देखता है वही समृद्ध को अनुभव करके तत्व को और दूसरे विमुख को समझ लेते हैं। मैं ब्रह्म का हूं ब्रह्म करने से तो राजा जी का हूं सत्यंग परम की वो ब्रह्म का भी प्रकाश है ब्रह्म का भी प्रतिष्ठा है मैं उनका हूं और उनका जो धाम जो राजा मुझे पहले विश्वास धामन ही ब्रह्म जी का अंतर्वत धाम अर्थात सबसे उत्तम उत्कर्ष को जब इतिहास करता है भगवान और राजा जी तो अपने पूर्ण प्रकाश है जहां पर श्याम सुंदर हजार वर्ष चक्कर मारते हैं चाहे वो जेठ का दुख भरी हो चाहे वो माघ का ठंडी हो। अभी आश्रम महाराज जी बोल रहे थे वृंदा जी जब घूमती फिरती देखती तो सब समय उनको राजा बनते ही पाते तकमान जितने सकी कहां से आ रहे हरिपाल मुदा हरि के पास से आ रहे हो तो नारायण उनका जगह कहां है राजा कौन है आप तो धाम को अपना धाम मान के रहता है क्योंकि उनका अपना कोई घर नहीं है वहीं पर अपना घर बना लिया है अपना खुशी बांध लिया है वही दिन रात अपना पिता है। क्यों गुरुदेव आपके अनंत अनंत जो कला है एक एक रूप की ध्वनि जब नृत्य करते तो अनंत को है अनेक मंत्र नाद मंजु नूपुरा रवस्थल उन सब स्वर लहरियों को ध्वनियों को मंत्रों को सीखते हैं सुनकर नित्य शिक्षा गुरु का है। बड़े ब्रज में राजा की और क्या है जीव देखो राजा है आगे राजा पीछे राजा मेरे बाएं दाएं राजा जिधर भी दृष्टि डालते हैं आपको भी देखते हर वृक्ष में हर लता में हर पता में हर मोर कोयल पतीजे में भी आपके ध्वनि को सुनते राधे 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 इसे लताओं को इन बताओं के अनुकरण करते हो जैसे काले हुए ऐसे हाथ को मिलाते गर्दन को मिलाते तो कहते इसी समीक्षण आत्मान आत्मान अपने स्वरूप को ऐसा विचार करके जहां मनु संगीता वहां पर इस बात को बताए नारद जी को चारों कुमारों ने सर्व कुमार संगीता में आत्मान सत्संग न्याय तापम बद्री मनोरम रूप जौवन संपन्न किशोरी प्रमला की किशोरी प्रमला की आत्मान सत्संग चिंतित तापम बद्री मनोरम जितने की सखी सहते है उनमें अच्छे को भी तात्विक रूप से चिंता और उस स्वरूप को प्राप्ति करके उस स्वरूप को उनके जो भगवान के जो आत्मा है राधा जी उनको लगा कृष्ण ने जो कृष्ण की जो आत्मा राजा जी आत्मा तो राजा का प्रोक्ता सत्ता रमना देव तो आत्मा राम यदि प्रोक्ता इसी भी तत्व मेरे हुए कृष्ण की जो आत्मा है प्राण की जो प्राण है वो राजा जी है ऐसे राजा जी अपने स्वरूप के द्वारा मन को लगा जैसे रघुनाथ पास इसी कुंड पर बैठ करके वो भजन की सारी प्रपट परिपाटी कैसे राजा जी का भजन होना चाहिए कैसे निष्ठा होनी चाहिए आ देवी उसमें बोले देवी है आशा भरे अमृत सिंधु मय कथंजी कालो मयाती कर्म करती स्वर से कृपा मुझा सच नहीं वकी में प्राणे ब्रजे न च बरूरु बकारी न मैं सब आस भरोस छोड़ करके केवल आपकी आदत पर यहां बैठा राजी का महादेव वो आशा एक अमृत है एक अमृत का समुद्र है जिसमें डूबने से उतरने से प्राण नहीं निकलता जीवन धारण हो जाता इस आशा से मैं कितने साल कितने वर्ष व्यतीत करते
केवल आपकी कृपा के पाने। राधा रानी कहती मेरी कृपा से क्या होगा, मैं मेरे लिए सबसे बड़ा मूल्य धन लोग कृष्ण है, उसको तुम ले लो बोले नहीं उससे हमें व्यक्त हो जाए, मुझे तो केवल आपकी कृपा चाहिए। यदि आप कृपा नहीं करें पर कृपा विधा सकती नहीं बनती मैं प्राणे बढ़े न चाहे बड़ो तो बकारी ना। अर्थात राधा जी की दास्या है, रोटी नहीं है, कृष्ण होगा बड़ा वस्तु लेकिन उनके लिए कुछ काम करे, उनके लिए तो खारा समूल है, खारे समूल से हमें क्या मिलेगा, हमें तो आपके माध्यम से उसको पाना है, उस पर उपभोग करना है। पहले उस पर महाराज जी बता रहे तत्त भाग इच्छा मरी जहाँ भाव साजुज्य बड़ा सुंदर चंद्रस्ती के पुस्तक भी महाराज जी सुंदर दर्शन सुनाए। विशेषता से रस्ता